Now, local media personality Nandi Madida is many things. A style icon, TV presenter and singer, but most importantly, she's a mother to two beautiful children and the wife to SA singer Zakes Mandweni. We catch up with Nandi to find out more of how she's been spending time in her family during lockdown and how they've been keeping busy. But first, let's hear some Say You Will.
Reporting live from the fortress, it's two lanes of courses. Just me and my gorgeous queen, Gucci Bamo, she's fist so salilogus. They keep running in mouth, begging me low, Missy Shanga, my potris, my tuchele babu. They don't know we moving as a unit. My kuzula na uwe, mpilwe niyam, futu bashula na nge Jewish. They mad cause I put you in the newest cabana. Ain't no better love than the one I know. You got your name branded all over my heart and soul. So sugar niswa yikoti man. Mangona when I'm veling on and just tumbe sam. Cause you're the only one I want, I get kamut. It's a wife thing, but I gotta do the right thing. My life thing, get you a nice ring, a Cartier bracelet, a bright link, diamonds.
It's such a vibe here in the loft. Afternoon Express is having the best time. Say you will, yeah, 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 Nandi, on that note. How are you doing, girl?
I am so good. This is why I love the show Afternoon Express. I mean, what a vibe. Look at you dancing. Look at yourself, okay? And what a strange but beautiful time to be alive. I'm sending love to everyone at Afternoon Express and, of course, the whole country, continent and the world. But you guys are actually really making it bright tonight for us. We really do appreciate you. That's why we love the show.
Thank you for bringing the music that brings that positivity to life. And speaking about positivity, I mean, on social media, you said, yeah, let's stay positive regardless of what we're going through and support one another, sending all the love and positivity. So what made you send out that message? And how has the national lockdown affected you personally and your family?
You know, the whole world over has had to tap into another dimension of survival, almost mentally. And you know, you have to understand that a lot of people live in toxic situations, whether unfortunately it's at their homes or whatever the situation may be. So being in a lockdown, especially from a financial perspective or just many aspects socially as well, it's hard for a lot of people to stay positive, you know, when they're real realities, you know, regarding such a lockdown. A lot of people have lost their jobs, you know, that the uncertainty of when this will end. So all I could almost communicate with everyone, because we're all going through this together, is the fact that all we have is our positivity, and from a mental perspective, to stay as positive as we can, knowing that this will also end soon. So soon we will overcome, because there's not necessarily anything tangible, but it's from a spiritual perspective that we need to know that we need to stay positive, and we are in this together, and we will get through this together.
Together, that is that togetherness, that unity.
Absolutely. And sorry, and also I must give a huge shout out to my family. They've also made it very bearable for me. I am blessed to have a beautiful family. They've just been incredible, you know. Toddlers, 1 and 3 years old. It's going down every second. It is going down. The one knows how to spell cat. The one messed up her forehead today because she bumped it. And she has a 5 head like mommy. So, you know. you know, and my son, of course, dancing with father. We having little parties because that's all we can do and not go out to family parties. But I think the most important thing is to stay positive. My husband is the very calm person because I struggle with a lot of anxiety as well, which I think is important for people to know, where obviously something, uncertainty can always bring your anxiety up, and just trying to find a way to be calm. So I've been exercising a lot. I've been eating as much as I used to when I used to be in studio with you guys. Food was delicious.
But you're looking good. You're looking good.
I've gotten my body back. as well as, you guys are so good to me. I love you guys. But also as well as the fact that I've had to tap into another sense of calm and serenity. And I think that's important, that if you're feeling alone and feeling you're the only one feeling anxious, a lot of people like myself are as well, you know. And that we need to be fine and we need to be calm and find ways to calm ourselves, yeah.
I'm so appreciative at the fact that you have called yourself out on experiencing anxiety, but not only that, you've given us some useful tips as to how to overcome this anxiety. Practical tips, exercising, eating well, and spending that quality time with the family. How is the family doing? I can hear those voices in the background.
Yes. So my daughter's fighting. I have the most incredible nanny. She's fighting with her right now. They love each other and they get each other. So they're at war right now because she doesn't want to dress. Standard procedure.
What's new?
And my son thinks he's a teenager, so he's just too mature for the situation. And my husband's making music as always. But it's always it's crazy. He's amazing. Like, I actually don't know what I'd do without my husband in this situation. But we've been laughing a lot, and the kids have been as good as they can be. I mean, they're 1 and 3 years old.
Yeah.
But I also, like I said, I genuinely feel we have had crazy moments with them. But that's what you love about family. I think everyone can relate to that, you know?
Yeah.
You know, the one time, for example, my son nearly broke his neck trying to jump off something because he really wants a trampoline.
You know,
and we get it. But with lockdown, at the time, we couldn't buy a trampoline. And he couldn't wait. I mean, scenarios like that. But it's been good. And I think also the best thing I've gotten out of this lockdown is learning how to cook healthy and be healthy. I just tapped into a side of myself that I didn't know existed. And that's wellness, and I think because we have time now, so thank you for all your fake cook recipes, everyone on Instagram. I see them.
We but got you, girl.
You're not helping my situation and our situation. So I'd like to thank all those also who you know, I've been looking at a lot of healthy recipes, you know, and just I mean, obviously, I have the good time here and there and cheat days, but I've actually been trying to be as healthy as possible, and that's helped me a lot.
Well, don't worry, girl. We got your back. Just head over to the Afternoon Express website, and we've got more recipes for you there to cook along with us. The plug. You know the plug, Moose. Another thing, though, that I'm sure that you're doing, look, your kids are extremely young, so there is no real homeschooling or curriculum. They're babies, right? But how have you kept them activated, kept their minds buzzing and busy?
Oh, no, you'll be shocked. My son is already, he's in proper school.
Hi, Bo.
And, yeah, he has classes. Oh, no, no, 3 years old, but he's got classes. He's one of the youngest in his class. But, yeah, we have classes from about, what, Hopper's 10. It's only really 30 minutes, and then they've given us different activities to do with the kids. But every day, it's actually the reason why, like I was saying, my daughter knows how to spell cats, because that's from him. Because he's learning how to spell cats, and, of course, phonics and maths. Not every day they are actually doing some kind of schooling. And, you know, it is tough. I mean, for example, as a toddler, of course, he doesn't have a curriculum per se, but to get them to sit down and listen to you when you're not a teacher, even at that age, because he knows he's teachers and he knows I'm not a teacher.
He's like, nah, you mommy, I can bend and shape and twist mommy's arm.
Absolutely.
Nandi. Absolutely. I'm so obsessed with you, and I love the family dynamic that you're breaking down for us here on Afternoon Express. We have got a good idea of how the Madita household looks like right now during lockdown. But don't move a muscle, because towards the end of the show, I really want to touch base with you as to why it's so important to create this generational wealth that you have going on with your family. I mean, hashtag kids with farms, right? And more of the work that you've been doing on social media.
Thank you. Much love. See you guys later.
See you later. Now, Nandi's incredible spirit during this tough time is a true reflection of that having a positive attitude is very important. So coming up, we meet community pharmacist Sham Mudli, who's passionate about the work he's doing in the Durban South Basin area and how it's earned him a nomination in Adcock Ingram OTC's Sponsors of Brave campaign. Don't go away.